Hey guys, it's Den. Firstly, I'd like to apologize. It's been a while since I put out a video. For those of you who've subscribed to me up to this point, that's my bad. I'm going to be putting out videos a lot more frequently than I have in the past, and they're going to start going up in value. I'm getting new software, I'm getting new cameras, working on a lot of different things. I'm also, as a side note, I'm also starting to work for a new company called Modern Dating. Keep an eye out. I'll post down links as soon as we're up and running. I'm going to be putting up articles there and everything else. Now, on to the subject of today. What I want to talk about today is something that's been really annoying me with certain people, and it's not just in success with women either. It's like success in approaching anywhere. Okay? What I call it is proper etiquette of approaching. The proper etiquette of approaching. Now, what do I mean by this? Okay, look at it this way. All right. When let's say you're walking through a mall and one of those people, those hand lotion people, walk up to you and you feel their disgusting energy, their inauthenticity coming up at you. How do you feel? Disgusting, right? Secondly, if they react poorly, how do you feel? Even worse. It makes it even worse. So the next time somebody approaches you, it's a downward spiral. Now, I'm not. People can do what they want to do. But I'm going to say this, if you're going to act that way, it's going to be worse for the approacher than it is for the approachee. Now, let me explain. Everything in life, you want to be a win-win, and if it's not, then it's cool, cut it off. So, next time you're in a club and you're approaching people, or next time if you do sales, you're approaching somebody, I want to say you do this. Okay, firstly, understand this. All right, one, you are allowed to approach. All right? There should be a law, there should be an amendment made about this. You are allowed to approach. You can approach as many people as you want, as often as you want. Awesome. But here's the flip side. Okay, if you can approach, the approachee can reject you at will and in any which way they want. Okay, they could say stuff about your mother, they can do this, that, they can scream at you, yell at you, say something about your fifth member and how tiny it is. But they can do whatever they want, and it's okay. All right. If anything else, if they do have that kind of negative energy and they do throw negative energy at you, it's honestly on them, and you should feel sorry for them because it's probably something bad's probably happening in their life, or it's just a bad personality characteristic that they are have inherited, and life's gonna have to beat out of them, or it will end up beating them up over the course of their lifetime, which is okay. So whatever, it's on them. Now, if you do get negative energy like that, be okay with it. All right, it's not a big deal. People are allowed to reject you. You have one of two choices. One, realize it's not you, it's them. Two, realize you just are not good enough yet for that situation. However you approach, you did it wrong. So in that case, you need to get better, not bitter. Better, not bitter. Here's a few things, few quick tips to help you out with that. I rarely get rejected nowadays. I don't get rejected nearly as much as I used to. I do from on occasion when I come across some girl in a bad mood, and even then I can flip it a lot of times. But I'll say this. Here's a couple few quick tips to make sure that you get rejected a lot less if you are getting rejected. Number one, always be positive. Positivity gives value. All right? It's value in itself. If somebody's having a negative day and you just hit them with positivity, they'll feel it and they'll flip. Or they'll be so welcome to your positivity, they'll naturally want to talk to you, even if they're not interested. And then they'll become interested once they find out you're a cool guy. Two, authenticity. If you aren't feeling positive at first, tell them how you're feeling. All right, be very open about it. Because whenever you fight something, let's say you're feeling very bad, who knows, somebody very close to you died, or maybe you had some trouble at work, maybe an ex of yours is blowing up your phone. All right, whatever it is, accept it. Firstly, accept it and understand that by approaching and being outgoing, your outgoing positive self will naturally come out as long as you don't fight whatever emotion you're in. So if you're feeling really sad, go up to the person and be like, "Hey, I just want to say I feel really sad today. I've been feeling really out of it all day today. But I know if I don't approach anybody or talk to anybody different, I'm gonna stay in this mood, and so I'm gonna extend myself out and I'm gonna talk to somebody. So hey, my name's Denton. Who are you?" And then from that, then you approach the next one and approach the next one and the next one. And eventually what will happen is you'll stop feeling negative. Your now going positive self will come out and you feel a lot better for it. Now, firstly, rejection, whatever. All right, you take that rejection, that's fine. All right, they're allowed to reject you in any which way possible. Yeah, but here's one more thing, one last note to take on them. Let's say you don't do this. Let's say you take the rejection terribly. What's going to happen is what I call negative looping. You're going to approach the next person, and you're going to approach them with that negative energy you're holding on to. And that person is going to want to reject you. They're going to sense that negative energy in you, and they're going to reject you because on the one side where positivity is a giving trait, negativity is a taking. Why would somebody want somebody who's leechy, who's taking? They're naturally going to reject you just like the last person did, and it's going to put you in an even worse mood. You're going to approach the next person in an even worse mood. So that, and that person should reject you in that case. That person totally should reject you. Why would you ever approach anybody other than positivity or giving energy? All right? Think 7 habits of highly effective people. All right? Okay. I hope that's very helpful. You're going to be seeing a lot more of these videos. With that being said, peace out.
And one night as I closed my eyes, I saw a shadow flying high. He came to me with the sweetest smile, told me he wanted to talk for a while.